Can we hear you? Can we hear the black? Oh, there we go. Good morning. Strange. Hello? That works. There we go. Sorry about that. Just testing it, and it does work. Excellent. Well, good morning, everybody. I'm glad to see you all today, and for later, whenever you watch it online again, wherever you're watching this, in England or even abroad, I want to say good morning, maybe good evening actually, could be for you. It's good that you can join us and join our in our celebrations. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are a supreme God. You created the heavens and you created the earth. You, being the supreme king, also created us. And you said that we were good. Not only did you create us, you wanted a relationship with us. So, Heavenly Father, we thank you that you always are crying out to us to come. And Lord, I thank you, Lord, for the obedience for all of us today, that we have come today. And many others are, even around the world, Lord, are going to come into your presence today and worship you, to fill your glory, to fill the world with your glory. That was the purpose of humanity, is to represent you. And Lord, forgive us how we may have not resented you this week. And that's why we come here humbly and say, Lord, help us. Give us your wisdom. In this tiring world that we live in, help us to have strength. Restore our bones today. Restore us where we are. Lord, I hope it's everyone's prayer today that we want to meet you. We want to be changed by you. Lord, we didn't wake up today just because we woken up. We came here, even though we may not realize, we came here because we want to meet with you. So Heavenly Father, hear our prayer today. We are here for you. That is the main reason to worship you in spirit and in truth. And by the blood of Christ, we can come in confidence today, in confidence, knowing that you love us. Because on the cross you said, it's finished. You even said to us, and probably always keep saying, Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing. And Lord, we don't know what we're doing. That's why we're here. We humbly come here. And Lord, we pray for more in England, Lord, to come and sit at your feet and to say, Lord, help me. I don't know what I'm doing. But you are the creator of heaven and earth. You created me. You said I'm good. So please instruct me in your ways, because your ways are good, because you're a good, good Father. We give you all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, everybody. Well, we're just going to go through some notices. Some are going to be a bit long today, and just please bear with me. Some are self-explanatory. Some of you heard before, so it'll be in your news and notes. And I'm just going to talk about it. I'm just going to keep going through. So you can see the board is self-explanatory, so I'll just go through the next one. Today, if you've come here today and you didn't know, today is lunch today with the church. Again, if you are hungry today, there is lots of food, so please, and if you didn't know, you're like, I didn't know about it, please stay. Please stay for lunch. Today really is really fellowship. It's really to get to know one another much more. If you feel like, well, I haven't brought anything, that's okay. As I said, bring yourself. You're here. You are here, and we want to get to know you more. So please, stay behind, and please do not say, well, I've not brought anything, I cannot come. You brought yourself. That's good enough. For me, that's good enough. And we always seem to have enough food. And if you haven't, we've got each other. So do not worry. Do not worry. So please, at the end of service, stay here, and please, at the back of the church, that's where we eat together. Okay, next one. And just to let you know, if we can have any donation, whatever you can give, it's for James, forgive me, for Salt Mine. And if you want to know more, you're thinking, hold on, what's this marathon and what's James doing? Speak to him. He will tell you where the money is going to. So again, thank you, James. So while we're eating, he'll be training. This is his last, I'm joking, so last month, and then you can do it. But April 23rd, he'll be doing the marathon. Next one. Talk about later. We'll move on. We'll talk about the evangelist later. Warm spaces. Has anyone heard of warm spaces? Hands up if you have. Ah, okay. So I'm talking to some of the converted already. Okay. Warm spaces is a place where, and at the moment some churches are doing this, where it's a place that many of us are finding the cost of living. Oops. Yep. That's the one. That was good. Next slide. Oh, he's gone. Okay. Thank you. You can read it up there, actually. I'm not going to read it all there. You can see it all here. It's where, again, where we can help as well. Warm spaces, sorry, is a place. Nikki, where's Nikki?
Yeah.
Do you want to quickly talk about warm spaces, quickly, briefly?
Okay.
Yeah, you can come up here, and you can use this microphone if you want. There you go. Thank you.
Okay, so warm spaces is basically...
together, so if they can't afford to heat their home, they can go into a warm space. So what we were thinking of doing on a Saturday morning between 9:30 and 11:30 is opening the back rooms for a couple of hours if people want to come and just be, and they can play with the toys. We can just sit and chat and have tea and coffee with them. So if anyone would like to support on a Saturday morning between 9:30 and 11:30, it doesn't have to be every Saturday, because we can do a rota system, then please come and see me and we'll make some plans. Thank you.
And the good news about this is the quicker we get volunteers, the quicker we can open it. So again, we need you. Again, we need you to come. Talking about help, next slide. Thank you. Sorry. Thank you, Peter. We've got here, and again, you may be new to this. It's me and Peter were talking, and I've used some of these services. Sometimes there are services that you are not aware of in this borough. And sometimes it's like digging for gold for getting these services. And we have got some. We're trying to start as a church to actually sort of know what is there out there. We've got here, we've got household support fund, free school meals, heater loan schemes, holiday activities and food programs, energy saving advice, money saving advice, and warm home fund. Peter Dean said, if you need a copy of this, come and see it. There's some basic information here. It may not just be for you, it may be someone else. I don't know about you, and I feel actually quite guilty of this, but sometimes I'm scared to talk to people because of the lack of education I have for services. You always think, oh my goodness, how can I talk to people if I can't help them? And actually, there are lots of services out there. And I think as a church, we need to know more what services are there so we can help each other, not feeling that we have to do everything when actually services are already there. Okay, so if you need to have a look at what's out there, and you're struggling, do not worry, we'll not judge you or anything. I've used some of these before, and again, don't worry, most of the people out really are using these things. So please come and see me or Peter Dean, who's in the back, and he will tell you much more about it. Next one. I think that's it, actually, the notices. Yes, birthdays. Birthdays this week. We've got Gail, and we have Phil. Is it you, Phil?
Yeah.
Yes, it's Phil. Sorry, I'm looking at you. Phil's looking at me like, yes, it's me. Sorry, Phil. So that's on Friday and Tuesday. Are you going anywhere at all? Any plans?
Tim and Sarah are coming home on Saturday.
Oh, that's it. That says it all, doesn't it? That's a birthday. Oh, that's fantastic. When are they? So how long are they staying for?
2 weeks.
Oh, that is fantastic. Oh, fantastic. Well done. Oh.
It's Shannon's birthday.
26, okay, so...
My son's birthday on the
2nd. So another one, your son's birthday, and you've got... Shannon, by the way, had graduation, didn't she?
She did.
She had a graduation, and how'd it go?
It went very well. It was done at Brighton.
I saw some pictures online, they were very nice. Yeah, I saw them, I didn't like them, but I did look at them, yes. I did look at them, so yeah, they were nice, so yes. No problem. So yes, also as well, is there any other celebrations? I've got one celebration in a minute which I'm going to make someone really embarrassed about. Anything else? Bethany, can you come up here quickly? Sorry, I'm going to embarrass you. But get used to it, because you're going to be on stage soon, so get used to it. As you know, my daughter, yes, I am being very biased right now and very proud of her. As you probably know, that she has been practicing and rehearsing for The King and I in the tour. There's a tour coming up. The last London rehearsal was finished this week. On Tuesday, she now goes up to the theatre on Tuesday and starts studying from Tuesday to Friday. And it's all up with all the gear and the lights and everything. And then on Saturday, it's her first performance. They are opening. Which I'm like, yes. So I hope you don't mind. Actually, we'll pray for everyone else as well, but I hope you don't mind. I want to pray for, obviously, protection and all that sort of thing that a father wants their daughter to have, because she has to go away. We've got to drop her off at the station and wait for 4 or 5. Actually, this time it's like 6 days she's away. Yeah, exactly. If your mothers and fathers, you're like, oh, yeah, I can see people like, oh, are you sad? Are you happy? How are you feeling? She's happy, yeah. She's like, yeah, I'm happy. Do you want me to come and visit you? No, it's okay, I'm happy, yeah. So, but she's really happy. Pray for us as parents. It's the first time we've let our daughter go. So, yeah, let's just pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for birthdays. Again, when you created us, you said we were good. So thank you, Lord. May you bless all the birthdays we have heard. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the great celebration that Tim and Sarah are back. Heavenly Father, what a joy that must be for the family. What a great present that is. So Lord, while they're there, I just pray, Heavenly Father, you'll provide with their provisions. You'll provide all they need, the family. But most of all, Heavenly Father, may they have that time they need together. May you just be with them, support them, give them peace, give them rest that they need also as well. But Lord, and give them safe travels as they come as well, safe mercies as they come and travel. Be with all their preparation, and thank you, Heavenly Father, for what they do, and thank you how they're coming home. Thank you so much. And dear Heavenly Father, I lift up my daughter to you. We lift up Bethany to you. And Lord, we thank you again for opportunity of being creative. We thank you, Heavenly Father, you are a creative God. And we thank you the gifts and talents you have given us are from you, because you created us. May Bethany never, and ourselves, never forget what we are good at, and what is good comes from you. And Heavenly Father, if that is the case, help Bethany have confidence that when she is having problems of her learning her lines or dancing, Lord, she can look up to you and just say, Lord, help me, the giver of gifts, refine my gift. So may Bethany know, Lord, the gifts and talents she has comes from you. And Lord, we thank you for that community. We pray that you will bind that community together strongly. And Lord, may just Bethany be herself and have a great time and give her protection. And may she be led by your spirit, Lord, to do all good things. Where there's things, Lord, that may be challenging, not, Lord, of you, may she be like a Daniel and say, no, I don't do that. I don't do that. So Heavenly Father, I pray you give her the spirit of Daniel, Heavenly Father, to just be the light in the darkness. And we thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you. We're getting there. Do the songs now? Yep. Before we the kid gets ready, I want to do some scripture up. It's Psalm 97. The Lord reigns. Let the earth be glad. Let the distant shores rejoice. Clouds and thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundations of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all the people see his glory. All who worship idols are put to shame. Those who boast in idols, worship him, all you gods. Zion hears and rejoices, and the village of Judah are glad because of your judgments, Lord. For you, Lord, are the most high over all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods. Let those who love the Lord hate evil. For he guides the lives of the faithful ones and delivers them from the hand of the wicked. Light shines on the righteous and the joy on the upright in our heart. Rejoice in the Lord, you who are righteous, and praise his holy name.
Today. I did come last week, but this feels like this is my first time this year because we were sick at the beginning of the year. So I just want you to look around you, and there's people of all different races, ages. We've got like little babies, we've got elderly not looking anywhere, but we've got people of all different ages, and we just need to celebrate. We've come together for one reason, to celebrate Jesus Christ, to celebrate what he did in our lives. That's why we're coming on a Sunday, to gather together, to have fellowship with each other, and we're going to have a nice meal afterwards. And so let's just enjoy it. As the children lead us, we're going to sing some songs, we're going to have fellowship. So let's just really celebrate the fact that we are saved, that we are in God's house, that our sins are forgiven, that when we die, we're going to go to heaven. And yes, you may have had a difficult week. I've had a difficult week. Tests, trials, responsibilities. But this is a place where we can kind of forget what happened this week, good or bad, and just focus on how beautiful it is for brethren, brothers and sisters to come together in unity and worship God. So let's stand and sing Amazing Grace. This is Amazing Grace.
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder and leaves us breathless in our wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you will take my place. That you will bear my cross. You lay down your life. That I will be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
Who brings our chaos
back into order? Who makes the orphans a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who rules the nail of with holy thunder? That's like the sun in all our royals. The King of glory, the King of all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You lay down your life. That I will be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. that you've done for me.
This is amazing grace.
This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You lay down your life. That I will be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
Father, we thank you for your amazing grace. And Jesus, we thank you that if it wasn't for your amazing grace, we would not be here today. And we just want to celebrate your amazing grace that saved us. Okay, we're gonna sing God is able. God is able. Here we go. Technology. Okay, let's go. God is able. He will never fail. He is the Almighty God. He's greater than all that we seek, greater than all we ask. He has done great things.
God is able. He will never fail. God, greater than all we seek, greater than all we ask. He has done great things, lifted up, defeated the grave, raised to life. Our God is able. In his name we overcome. For the
God is with us.
God is with us. God is on our side. He will make a way. Far above all we know, far above all we hope. He has done great things. Lifted up, defeated the grave, raised to life.
Verse 1 again.
God is able. He will never fail. He is almighty God. Greater than all we seek, greater than all we ask. He has done great things. Lifted up, defeated the grave.
Verse 2.
God is with us. God is on our side. He will make a way. Far above all we know, far above all we hope, He has done great things. Lifted up, defeated the grave, raised to life. Our God is able. In His name we overcome. For the Lord our God is able. God is with us. Will go before. He will never leave us. He will never leave us. God is for us. He has open arms. He will never fail us. He will never fail us. God is with us. He will go before. He will never leave us. He will never leave us. God is for us. He has open arms. He will never fail us. He will never fail us. Lifted up, defeated the grave, raised to life. Our God is able. In His name we overcome. For the Lord our God is able. Lifted up, defeated the grave, raised to life. Our God is able. In His name we overcome. For the Lord our God is able. In His name we overcome. For the Lord our God is
through, but I just want to encourage you to focus on the Lord and to remember that God is able. Sometimes we look at our situations, our circumstances, and we think, this is impossible. And as the song says, our God is able. So whatever the situation is, I want you to bring it to the feet of the cross now. That which you thought was too difficult, which you thought God's not going to be able to fix that, I want you to leave it right now at the cross. Leave it at the feet of the Master and put your faith, put your trust in His ability to take you through it, because God is able.
Jesus said that we should pray without ceasing. He said that because He knows that your adversary never stops plotting against our lives. You'll face many issues, you'll face sicknesses, you'll face challenges at work. You'll face all kinds of things in your marriage. But Jesus says, pray without ceasing. And my Father and I are always at work. So we continue praying. God is always at work. He may not work, but God is able. This morning we'll continue to pray for those who are going through a lot in Iran. You know what's going down there. We need to lift them up in prayer. Ukraine, and we pray for how's David anyway? Any updates from David and Marianne? Okay, he's recovering. Okay, you thank God for answered prayer. And also Stan, any updates? Continue to intercede on his behalf, and all those who are going through any health issues, we'll continue to pray for you. When God does it, the Bible says when God delivered you, we'll be like we're dreaming. You won't even know when he does it and how he does it, and he wants to bring glory and honor to himself. Any other issues that you want to pray for? David had a fall and he's still in a lot of pain. We need to continue to pray for him. Granville?
Continue to pray for some older members of this fellowship in the realm on time who can't join us now. So Ken and Nina, Stan, of course, and Isabel, and Sheila, and all those I can't remember.
Shall we lift them up as a group? The Lord knows who they are. Sandra?
Lift them up.
No problem. Okay, any other issues we need to lift up before the Lord? And we'll pray for any issues in people who are having any problems in their marriages and they want to see their loved ones come to the Lord. We'll continue praying for those. We can't forget to pray for the Church of Christ, because the enemy does not sleep. He continues to plan his plans against our church. Okay, let us pray. I'm just going to ask that we start off praying the Lord's Prayer together, and then I'll carry on from there. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you because you're God Almighty. We come to you because you've asked us to always pray without ceasing, Heavenly Father. And we thank you for the name of Jesus as above every other name. Yes, every sickness is a name. Every problem is a name. But we have a name that's greater than any sickness, any disease, any problem before you, Father. And Father, we lift up all these issues before you. Father, we thank you for David. We thank you for his life. We thank you because you have started the healing process in his body, Heavenly Father. Father, we pray for peace upon him, Father. We pray for his wife, Heavenly Father, as she looks after him. Grant her the grace and the peace, Lord, to be able to look after him, Heavenly Father. We thank you for their lives. We thank you for Stan. Father, we pray for Stan that, Lord God Almighty, continue to do your work in him and through him to the glory of your name. Father, we lift up all those in the war-torn areas of Iraq and Ukraine, Father God. Father, we pray that your peace that surpasses all understanding continue to rule and rule over that nation, Father God. We pray for the leadership of those nations, Heavenly Father. And Lord, you will be able to turn their hearts around. As it is written that the hearts of the kings are in the hands of the Lord, and he is able to turn them wherever he wishes. And Father, we pray in Jesus' name, oh Father, that Lord, you arise in your power, in your wisdom, and in your glory to show forth your love for the people. Because we know, and as it is written, you loved the world so much that you gave your only begotten Son, Jesus, Father. And Father, even as we are yet sinners, Father, you die, you send your Son to die for us, Heavenly Father. And Father, we thank you. I thank you for every man, every woman under the sound of my voice that has going through any issues of illness, Father God, any issues in their home, Father, at work, Heavenly Father. Father, we lift them up before you. And Father, we pray that your peace that surpasses understanding, Father God, rule and reign in their homes, oh Father, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we pray, oh God, that anyone that does not know you, Father, we pray that, Lord, you reveal yourself to them, oh God. Because it's written, Heavenly Father, that no one comes to you unless they're drawn by the Father. And Father, I ask you by your Spirit. It's not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. And Father, we thank you for your church, Heavenly Father. And Father, we come against every plans of the enemy, Father God, to hinder, to sabotage the work of your glory. And we pray in Jesus' name, oh God, that you will be glorified in all that we do, Father. And we commit everyone into your hands, Father, for your safekeeping. Lead us and guide us, Lord, by your Spirit, oh Lord. We thank you and we praise you. We ask you all this in the mighty, powerful name of Jesus. Amen and amen.
Yeah, I'll use this one. If the children would like to go to their groups, we've got some at the back. If there are babies here and they need to go to the creche at the back, they're more than welcome. Let's just pray for the children as they go out. Dear Heavenly Father, we know how much darkness there is, and especially, Lord, against with the young people. And Lord, we pray that these will be the next leaders, that you can train them into the light, and they will burst through the darkness in your light. So Lord, teach them while they're young, so when they're old, they will know, Lord, how they are trained. So Lord, be with the teachers, Lord, today. Equip them in what they need equipping for. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Just for the little ones, not the teens yet. Sorry. Sorry about that. They're like, can we go now? Not yet. Kenny has put down, I'm going to blame Kenny for this one. Kenny's put down here in evangelism. He wants to talk a bit more about evangelism, which actually ties well with us. And I want to tell you that we haven't got a overhead yet. But the leader, as you know, the team leaders went away this year for a leadership day, and obviously we were wanting to go to find out what the purpose of God is. Guess what? It hasn't changed. Maybe the strategy's changed, but actually seeking God's purpose is exactly the same as any. Go and tell and disciple people in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Baptize in the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. That is the message. So there was nothing new under the sun. We didn't go there and go, oh, we found something new. However, I believe there's strategies to get there. I don't think God's word changes, but sometimes strategy does. As you know, we're very busy in life, so things aren't even looking here. We've got visuals. Things do change, but the word of God doesn't. So we, when we were leadership away, we had a gentleman coming and talking about evangelism. And for some of you, evangelism may be scary, but just to break it down in case you don't know the jargon, sometimes church jargon, what is the word evangelism? It's really to tell about Jesus. Tell about Jesus. Now, for some of us, that may be easy. I'm very aware. Well, that's easy. We're Christian. We should do it normally. Then there's others. Help. How do I do it? I'm scared. And that's okay, too. That's okay. And one thing that this gentleman brought us was just teaching, really, how to evangelize people. And again, some people may say, well, we don't need teaching. I could always say, well, then why are we not doing it then, as in multitudes? I know some of you are doing it, but as a church, and actually multiple at the church, there's two things normally that are suffering in church. One is prayer, it's the lowest, and evangelism. I'm not saying that in a bad way, but evangelism is something that the churches are not doing as much. We're almost waiting and expecting people to come through doors. Well, we have been blessed for that. People have seen us. It's been amazing. But what did Jesus do? He went out. He went fishing. Fishermen of when? He went out to bring people in. And then he discipled them to keep them. And that's one thing I think as a church this year, we really want to emphasize this year, is one, to go out, to keep. And then also challenge you. It's one more thing we have, church is not doing for a long time, is also send people out. Not when people leave this church, they die. It may be some of you actually may be here for a short time to do some church planting, to go somewhere else. And this is what I would like almost this church to be doing, is also training people and sending people out. Or even some people may move because they get married or they get older. Like, again, not putting for James. Who knows where James could go? Who knows in the future? And it'd be great if we can send him out. It'd be really great if we can teach him here and send him out. And what blessings we've had, example, he can bless others. So the days, I want to let you know, sorry, Kenny, taking all his time here. The days we've got at the moment we are looking at is on Saturday. So Saturday, it's either March the 11th or March the 18th. It's going to be a full day from about 10 to 4. It's a full day where we're going to learn about what we're going to do. We're going to try to condense how we talk to people about how do you meet Jesus. Sometimes we can go on forever, but people haven't got the time. So they show you how we condense it. And this is a scary bit, but the fun bit. We're going to practically do it and go out. I know, scary, isn't it? It's quite scary. Now, what I'm going to do now is actually introduce Kenny, who does evangelism, and he's probably going to share some stories. I don't know what he's going to do, actually. But he's going to come and share about evangelism, hopefully the fruit of it. It is scary, but it's very, very fruitful. Just imagine, for some of you, you came here and you came to Christ because someone told you. If it wasn't for that evangelist, you wouldn't be here. Just a thought there.
As Pastor Dan was saying, we're not singing yet. We're not singing yet. I love the enthusiasm. Love it. as Pastor Dan was saying, we have an outreach in the church that's we meet here at 4:30 and we go out on the streets. But again, that's not set in stone, so it can be any day. If you feel like you would like to just come and you can't make that day and you want to come on a different day, then speak to me. We can accommodate you. We can be Monday, it can be Tuesday, it can be Wednesday, between 4 and so on. But you may be here and you say, you know what, I'm not a street evangelist, because not everyone's called to be a street evangelist. So that is not the purpose of it. We're not here to say, you come out with me at 4:30 and become a street evangelist. That's not the purpose of it. That's not the point. In fact, if you don't come out, but you do share your faith with people where you are, that's probably more important. So it's not about, we're not going to reach the whole of South Ryestate by coming out 1 hour with me. So what it is really about is about, as Pastor Dan was saying, about being able to share your faith as and when the opportunity arises in whatever environment you find yourself in. It could be school, it could be college, it could be work, it could be the supermarket, it could be the petrol station, it could be, you know, just walking down the street. So wherever, you know, what we also want to do is hear testimonies and encourage. So I think that one of the things that Pastor Dan was saying, we don't just want to be an inward-looking church, we want to be outward-looking. Because the Bible says that there's a river inside of us that flows out, not a lake. A lake is stagnant, but a river flows out. And sometimes and I just want you to look and ask yourself, and it's not trying to put guilt or condemnation on you, because I'm asking myself the same question. If you look at 2022, ask yourself, how many times, of course we're not trying to score points, but how many times did you share your faith? I'm asking myself, did I share my faith in 2022? There's been some years that have gone by where not even one person I shared my faith with. You say, well, I wasn't living in I wasn't hibernating, I wasn't isolated, I was amongst people, but I never shared my faith. And maybe, you look back on 2022, did you share your faith? And I think we should be sharing our faith at least once a week, I think, at least, as the opportunity arises, you know, at least. And they do come, that's the thing, these opportunities, they really, really do come. It's going to share a short story. It's in the Bible where this woman, her husband died. It's in 2 Kings chapter 4. And she goes to the prophet and she said, "My husband is dead. And the creditor has come to take my two sons to be slaves. Help me." And the prophet said to her, "What do you have in the house?" And she said, "I haven't got anything in the house." And that's how a lot of people feel when it comes to evangelism. I don't have anything. I haven't got the skills. I haven't got the know-how. I can't do it. I haven't got anything. And the prophet said, she said, "Well, actually, I have got something. I've got a little jar of oil." And you may say, don't you? Your testimony is your little jar of oil. What God has done in your life is your pot of oil. What did the prophet say? He said to go and pour out the oil that you have into other vessels. And as she did that, it started multiplying. And that's exactly how it is. You take what you have. You might think it's so small. It might be just a smile, being friendly to someone. It could be just a kind word. It could be just saying, you know what? Okay, I'll tell them, I will pray for you about that. That might be, you know what, that might be all that you can do. God will take that and God will multiply it. So it's not about being some big evangelist who goes up randomly to people on the street and prays for them. It's not about that. It's about the little thing that you have. And it could just be your testimony at work. It's amazing how God will open the door for you to share your testimony at work. There was a supply teacher in and we were talking and she asked me, "How did I meet my wife?" And so I just told her I met my wife, how God brought us together. There you go, that's my testimony, simple as that. And she goes, "Okay, so how did you, so you're like a committed Christian?" I said, "Yes, how did you come to faith?" And so on and so forth. You know, it's just about being open and sharing. And I want to ask, Pastor's got a testimony. I also want to ask my wife of a testimony of just simply sharing your faith where you are. You know, you could be in the supermarket, you could be at the petrol station, you could be at your daughter's auditions. So I'm going to start with them.
I don't know how to share, because you put me on the spot actually the other day, but again, God never wastes anything. But from the King and I, I've been going to sort of take Bethany into London and waiting. And we've been building a community. And we're just sitting there. And again, forgive me, I know it's very basic what I'm going to say, but we've been spending time with each other. And I want to say about evangelism, evangelism sometimes can be time. We hear sometimes short, and then sometimes it's going to be time. Like we've heard with Nikki, it was years and years and years, and you see it. So again, different characters, so don't worry. And I think we're all trying to show you, evangelism has different kinds of flavors. And when the King and I, and again, I was shocked. I kind of felt I knew these people within 2 days. We're going around the table. They were asking us questions. How are you? How are you? And we were listening. And that sounds a strange concept, but everybody was listening. And then by the week, and then by the second day, then they're asking, right, what do you do? It was amazing, actually. I was like, wow, this is what community looks like. What do you do? And then I said, oh, I'm a pastor. And then this woman goes, what's a pastor? What is that? You know, I think she's thinking, pastor, really? What is, you know, really, what's a pastor? She had no idea. So I jokingly said, well, have you ever watched Vicar of Dimbleby? I didn't, yeah. And she kind of laughed, actually. And she said, I said, yeah, well, we help people, we counsel. Oh, wow, I've never heard that before. That was one. Again, it's never heard. Then there's another guy, and I knew this guy was almost, I think, was trying to witness to me. For 2 days, I was listening to him he's come from Tibet, and he's into Buddhism, but he's met the Dalai Lama. Met him many times, and the way he was talking, he's done art, and I think this guy was really trying to witness to me, bless him. And I listened for days and days. For some reason, God was almost saying, be quiet, which obviously is not me. So for 2 days, I was listening, the philosophy after philosophy after philosophy. And again, to give you another tool of evangelism, listening is a great skill. It sounds strange, but sometimes you're getting bored, but you actually hear snippets. And I just, because sometimes when you say, I don't know what to say, good, because you haven't listened to that person. Does that make sense? Sometimes we said, I don't know what to say. Good, be empty, because it's awful if you come with an agenda. Don't come with agenda. If you really care for someone, you're coming for their agenda. To listen, I was listening and listening, and he's giving us philosophy. I need to cut long short, because it wasn't a big story. We're still going through a process. But he was asking questions, and he didn't really know much about Christianity. And it was really interesting when he just said simply, he said, well, in the Bible, and I said lovely things. Well, have you read it? Well, not really, but I've heard about it. And it's been amazing that not many people know much about it. They've all these preconceived ideas. And if you've got the truth, that knowledge will set people free. You know that. A lot of it basically was, well, if God is so loving, why is somebody... And I was shocked because he's such a philosopher. We're all talking about like finding a middle ground at first, about everyone should be good. But then he'd come and say, well, if God is a good God, why is there so much evil? And I had to rub my head, and I used his own philosophy. I said, come on. Even if you're a Buddhist, if you followed your way, surely. And he said, oh, yes. So I said, it's your fault, not ours. And then we talked about forgiveness. But he couldn't understand forgiveness. He really couldn't understand it. But it came back to, which is really good, to talk about the Big Bang. I said, whose property is this? He said, well, it's not. It just happened. I said, yeah, but you're a philosopher. Surely you think there's a property of this. No, 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 no. So for him, he had no concept of a creator, so hence there was no reason to be forgiven. And when I did give him forgiveness and told him about the cross, he got angry, quite angry. And he said, what? If I just killed someone and asked forgiveness, I'll be forgiven, that's it. I said, you'll be forgiven in Christ, but you still have to pay the penalty of what you've done. And I think that was shocking, because I think he's heard bad theology of like, when you're forgiven, everything's great. No, if you kill someone, you still go to prison. But again, there was a lot of, and I want to encourage you, there's a lot of misconceptions out there that people don't understand. And I'm glad I heard, because he was asking, as a philosopher, I thought he knew a lot. He actually knew nothing about Christianity. And it's almost, some of it was just like, oh, well, you do this, you do. I said, no, I don't. I don't. And well, how old's the earth? How old is this? And when we had a conversation in intellect, because if you're an intellectual people, this may help you. He was, and then what I did in the end, though, which I would recommend you do if you can. In the end, I realized, and I told him, I said, me and you, we're going to have good conversation, but you're coming philosophy, I'm coming from God. I said, philosophy will not save me. And then I said, I'm going to use something in the Bible. And again, I've done this twice now, and it stops the conversation. I have no intelligent words. All I can offer you is a cross of Christ. And it's about a relationship. Do you want it? That's up to you. Conversation went dead. Went dead. And that's all I said. I didn't pray for him, but I think what Stella said, it was a seed. I just said, I'm teaching to you about relationship, not philosophy. And he said, because I'll be honest and I'll say to you, there'll be times, and I hope you feel this, you cannot philosophize philosopher. You know, we're dumb people, really. It's good, you know, we as Paul says, I'm not intelligent. All I bring is the gospel of the cross. That's all I teach. So sometimes, and I'll be honest, I was shocked. I loved it. God, and I know Stella's had this as too, and that's why I tried to say, listen, and then open your mouth, because God was giving me things I never knew was there. We're there for hours, and I was like, where's that coming? Well, we know now. When you don't know what to say, God will give you it, and try it. This is all about encouraging. Just try it, but have time. Again, some of it can be time. You've got neighbors already. Keep listening. You've got the opportunity. Others could be like Stella. You're walking and you're going to your opportunity of just going shopping and you get that gut feeling. Just start by saying hello and the conversation will. And if they just say bye, then you move away. But we're going to know more about this in the teaching. I actually want to save this for more of the teaching opportunity in March. And you'll get to know the opportunities. That evangelism is so vast. And maybe some of you already are doing it already without knowing it. So I want to encourage you. Thank you, Kenny.
If the children come up, we're just going to sing one song because the time has gone. And then the teenagers will go out to Sundays. If we could have a complete, please. Feel free to stand.
Complete.
Feel free to stand or sit, however you feel comfortable.
Restores me again.
So I lift my eyes to you. In your strength will I break through. Touch me now. Let your love fall down on me. And know your love dispels all my fear. Through the storm I will hold on, and by faith I will walk on. Then I'll see beyond my Calvary one day. I will be complete in you.
Listen again, here I am.
Here I am, oh God. I bring the sacrifice, my open heart. I offer all my life, I look to you, Lord. Your love that never ends restores me again. So I lift my eyes to you, Lord. In your strength will I break through, Lord. Touch me now. Let your love fall out on me. I know your love dispels all my fears. Through the storm I will hold on, and by faith I will walk on. And I'll see beyond my Calvary one day. I will be completed. So I lift my eyes to you. In your strength will I break through. Touch me now. Let your love fall down on me. I know your love dispels all my fears. Through the storm I will hold on, and by faith I will walk on. Then I'll see beyond my Calvary one day. I will be completely new.
Then I'll see
beyond my Calvary one day. I will be completed.
Let us pray as we prepare to hear the word. Dear Heavenly Father, that is the prayer of this church and for our heart, that we will be complete in you. That we pray for the world, we pray for our communities, that completeness comes by meeting you at the cross. Because Lord, you told us when we are weak, you are strong. When Christ was weak on that cross, his strength can utter, "Father, forgive them. They didn't know what they were doing. It is finished." Lord, we saw how you overcame. In your weakness, you overcame and gave us strength. And death did not hold you. On the third day, you rose again. And you showed us the strength in you. Lord, we are weak. And we come to you today by hearing your word. And Lord, we want to hear your word to be complete. There are areas in our lives, Lord, that maybe only us know, that are dark. And Lord, we know that you pierce, in your word, you pierce that darkness by your light. So Heavenly Father, as we hear the word of God today, may our hearts be open to receive. Receive your forgiveness. As I hope people have learned and listened today, that forgiveness comes from you alone, not by our works, not by our false guilt, not by our striving. It comes by letting go, which actually is the hardest thing to do. Like God says, lay it down. Lay it down. So Heavenly Father, maybe we've laid it down many, many times, but you tell us to confess, and confession is an ongoing thing. You tell us to work out our salvation. It's an ongoing thing. Lord, we're on a journey. We're on a journey. Help us not to be like that lake where we're stagnant and we stay still. Lord, we're on a journey, and there is no condemnation in you, but just love. You love your children. You love us so, so much. So, Lord, we pray now for the word of God, what we're about to hear, that it penetrates our hearts and minds so we can walk out feeling more complete in you. We praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We're now going to continue the Daniel series. I just want to say, if anyone has done that prayer quietly, again, you're not alone, so please, at the end of the service, come and see me, and there's some leaders here. Actually, leaders, stand up where you are. Leaders, there's Nikki. There's some leaders there. So please, if you've said that prayer or something you want prayer for, don't leave without receiving. You can sit down. Thank you. Please don't leave this place without prayer. And again, I hope this word will touch you. This is what we're all about, and people watching, this is what we're all about. We do need our Lord to be complete. We need the Lord to be complete. So please, this would be the thing I'd hate for you to go to leave and go through what you heard, Kim. Oh, it's terrible, isn't it? Going through to be humbled. But the Lord is pursuing you, so give it up today if you have. If you want to talk it through with someone, well, again, we are here for you. If not, we've got the food as well. Let us I just want to pray now to conclude our service. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you that you do pursue us. We thank you that you are patient with us. Dear Heavenly Father, this may be a hard one, Lord, but you do humble the pride. And dear Heavenly Father, forgive us where we have been prideful. But Lord, thank you, Lord, for that other promise we've seen today, that you always forgive. You always want to call us because you sent your Son to die for us, to say it is finished. So Heavenly Father, I just pray today, if people have made that commitment today or later on when they're watching, that they can speak and get to know the community, God's community. They're not alone. We're never planned to be alone, planned to be together, that we can confess to one another and help one another in this journey of life. And we just pray, Heavenly Father, for this week coming along as well. We pray for your strength. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, everyone. And if I don't see you, you're not sticking around, have a wonderful week. But it'd be great to see you in there, and we can have some time of fellowship.